All right, some good sound bites today on 1460 KXNO on the Morning Rush and Sports Fanaticks on the Afternoon Fish Sticks with Daddy Williams and Ross Baby. But I got to start off with this floppy joke.
Wall has totally revolutionized beard grooming with Wall's 2-in-1 vacuum trimmer. It not only delivers the finest in precision trimming.
Made you think this. Was it, or what, is this just, did I represent that quote that you heard?
Yeah, you were good.
Okay.
I listened to his press conference on the cycle.
All right. She got off.
The Cyclone website that I always do after every game.
This is going to be. I think both of these teams can have expectations.
It was in hour two. It's fucking floppy joke. It's fucking
longest
funny.
Arms fan of anybody besides Kreener and.
When you say floppy, that's the first thing that comes to my mind. Let's talk to Pete and Clive. Pete, once they probably would have been a
four seed. Derrick, you need Sharon called back.
Yeah, part of it is Shayok is an emotional player. He was kind of their leader on the floor, and when he wasn't shooting well, his defense didn't look so good, and then suddenly everybody else was kind of off. But
the air, and it's to have really good conversations, and another listener hears it and goes, yeah, screw Bannon. We're further away from some of the garbage, and this is one of those things.
I just want the video game back.
You just keep repeating the garbage.
I'm fine with the players getting played. I don't care. I just want the video game back. Find a way for me to have the video game.
And it's a fight.
I want to have with them. I want to recruit. I want to set my own schedule. I want to set my own uniforms. I want to go the alternate blacks for the clones.
We all do. So we've got to get on the same page and figure out who to fight. And it's got to be the right enemy. Every time that you throw ire towards Ed O'Bannon and another listener hears it and goes, yeah, screw O'Bannon, we're further away from the solution.
Chris, ultimately the problem is this. The amount of money the NCAA hibernate
5-0.
The money they print everywhere. So instead of sharing $30 million and opening up the floodgates for having to share everything else, they said, take your $30 million or whatever we make up this game.
It's coming up.
Screw you because
Derrick from New Sharon calls back.
$5
billion. Drops the ultimate floppy joke.
Appreciate the call. That's a good call. You're a good caller. Call anytime. 515-284-5966. Did Derrick from New Sharon call back? I said we got to talk to him. Matt and Ken, hold on. You guys are coming up next. Derrick, you back from New Sharon?
Yeah. Oh, my God. When I called in last time, I didn't know Cam Marr split.
Yeah, he's gone. He's transferred.
Fired up for Cam.
But the other thing I wanted to tell you, fellas, is you know what Floppy said when Dwayne died?
Oh, what was that?
See, it's a horrible joke.
What did he say?
Because Floppy was the dummy.
He's a dog.
And Dwayne was the
ventriloquist.
Okay.
Was this like a bit or did it happen?
No, the entire show was Dwayne and Floppy. And Floppy was the dummy.
Oh, Williams. Oh, Daddy Williams. All right, back to this morning. The morning trash.
Like, in all honesty, turning on the microphone and being able to talk to you guys and hit buttons and play music, like, that is what I was born to do.
Well, what sucks for me is, like, I have all this energy, and I'll start writing things down. Okay,
we're going to do this. We're going to go work out. Then when I put my workout time like 4 p.m, it's like, oh my God, there's no way I'm going to go work out now. I'm too tired. And then my wife, she's like totally giving up on me in any relationship way because it's like 7:30, 8 o'clock at night. She goes, what are you doing? I'm like, sleeping.
Jeff says, I think the moral of the story is we need to get Sean a higher paying job.
We try.
We're trying.
We're trying. We're really, really trying. Reverend Ray says, inhale, exhale. He's tweeted a picture of his wake and bake this morning. Attaboy, Ray.
Want me to smoke weed?
No, we don't want you to smoke weed.
I don't go down that path. I don't do drugs.
It wouldn't hurt for him to try edibles or something. You get awfully anxious. You could have a marijuana prescription if you lived anywhere where it was legal.
That'd be entertaining.
Sean on weed.
Turn the mic on. Trav goes, take your edible this morning. You good? Chilled out?
No. This isn't the time of day you take it. Oh, this isn't?
When do I take it?
When do I take it?
Heather, best thing that...
Microdosing, John.
All the great things you've done for me, that's...
Introducing you to melatonin.
Cannabis, baby. Yes,
I would have never did it. I would have never went and got it. Heather went and got it for me. She dropped it off my work.
Hooking him up.
I'm able to get at least 6 hours of sleep every night.
You know, you're close to weed, too.
Yeah, really? Owen says he likes the... Owen likes the melatonin, too.
I bet Owen likes the weed, too.
He said he was just staying up all the time because he couldn't sleep.
And maybe it's a mind thing. Like, it totally could be just, like, a total mental thing.
Yeah.
But to me, it relaxes my body, and I just shut off.
Yeah, so does this.
It's just great.
Darth Vader says, Sean, I've worked out for 20-plus years, and anything more than two...
I'll walk around with it. I'm Sean Roberts. Here's my medical marijuana card.
But I don't...
Even got in a fight with bar staff. But no, we're not gonna press charges. Both were released at $1,000 bail. And actually, one of them had to go to the hospital because of an injury. When you throw a punch, it might do damage to you. And actually, it might have been a good ploy because the jail refuses to process somebody if you have an injury. Like, you got to go to the hospital first. It's pretty smart. But the cops went to the hospital and then charged him with disorderly conduct.
Reverend's trying to get me to apply for a medical marijuana card.
Why don't you?
He sent me the application.
Do it, man.
Baby.
Any of you can
Med Pharm.
Walk around.
Hey, you go there and just talk to the people, Sean.
I don't smoke weed.
That's fine. You don't need to.
You just want me to have it.
I just want you to have it.
Okay.
There you go.
Sean tries. The next Sean tries. At least go to Med Pharm.
5966. Interact with us on Twitter, Cakes in the Morning Rush. When we come back, we'll have the play.
All right, see if we can get this 5-0 anything in here. There's classic.
Do you know who your boyfriend or girlfriend is texting? Are you concerned they may be hiding something? LocateCheaters.com allows you to search and confidentially. Find out who your loved one is talking to.
Cheaters.com? What the fuck, Travis?
Address and location. For a limited time, you can search phone numbers for less than $1. Don't lose another sleepless night.
Search phone numbers for less than a buck.
Go to LocateCheaters.com now and find the truth. That's LocateCheaters.com.
It's not available in every state.
Your attention, please. This is...
The Morning Rush. The Morning Rush. With Travis Justice and Heather Burnside.
This is 1460 KXNO, Des Moines Sports Station.
Hour number two of The Morning Rush. Good to have you along on a Tuesday, the 26th of March. I'm Travis. He's Heather. He's Sean. Sean's all better now. He went to the...
A layup. And...
Brutal.
Flow. Kinnick Water Tower.
That was just going to a game. We were going to bring Owen's grandparents down to see him at KU so they could see the campus because they hadn't seen it before. And the spring game was like on the 13th. So we decided, well, maybe we'll do that weekend.
When is it?
April 13th.
Trav, I got an idea.
What's that?
I'll go with you, and then Owen and I can go out and hit the bars.
Oh, man. Before we get to my question for 5-0, I think Reverend Ray has a question for 5-0. By the way, good morning, 5-0.
Hey, what's happening?
Not much, man. Here is Reverend Ray, a guy I'm sure you know very well. Reverend?
Good morning. Hey, thanks for the love. Hey, just a couple quick questions for 5-0. since he's a pretty hip guy, he's down with a lot of the new music and got kids and stuff. So if he can give me the name of these artists or bands that these nicknames are associated with. The first one, a couple of softballs. Little Monsters, who's that associated with?
I have no idea.
Or isn't that Lady Gaga?
Thank you. You feel free to answer, you guys, if you for 5-0.
Hey, we're a package deal. So.
And then, okay, what about Swifties?
The Twisties?
Swifties? That's Taylor Swift.
Okay. Okay, what about Juggalos?
That's Insane Clown Posse.
All right.
that was a little bad. All right.
Maggie.
That's not. Not.
We all got together.
Our local heroes.
Didn't they just kick a guy out of their band?
There is a lawsuit going on.
There was some internal trouble going on there. Okay, now the final one, and let's see if you get it. Asthmatics.
I don't know that
one. The Spasmatic?
Air Supply?
No, the
Air Supply.
I'm Spasmatic. What?
Oh, I should have known that. I'm a music fan.
Got my hash pipe. Enjoy the smell of freedom at the show.
It's happy hour.
Wow.
I got my hash pipe.
Little known facts.
Enjoy the smell of freedom.
I got 5-0 Weezer tickets for Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Ooh, wow.
Yeah.
That's what night is that? Right, what night is that?
Thursday. It's Thursday night.
Wow. Let's see if Mark wants. Mark has a question for 5-0. What's up, 5-0? Or what's up, Mark? What's up, 5-0? Mark, I'm all confused.
Sorry, I called in. I do not have a question for 5-0. I do have a question for you, Travis. Are you really going to go to a Kansas Spring game? I mean, the line is Kansas plus 10.
I'm going to see my son, and right. It just would, you know, it's Les Miles night. I just thought, well, why not?
Yeah. All right.
I know, I'm a loser. Not really. Thanks, 5-0.
Yeah.
You're going to see your kid, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nothing being a loser. You're not a loser.
My son has made me so happy. I mean, every time he calls me, he's in a great mood. And I'm like, oh, my God, this is such a different kid than when he lived at home.
What's different?
Well, I think he's growing up. I think he's, you know, I think he
He seemed really interested.
Well, that's good. And I think we made it somewhat easy for him. We weren't.
Well, he was very complimentary of it afterwards, right?
Yeah.
So what? Local dude, Sean.
Yeah, he was local.
Oh, he's local.
Those positions or that, you know, the guard group.
Pixies, the opening band for Weezer. He probably does and doesn't know it. Look up Where Is My Mind and Monkey Gone to Heaven. They're a great, great indie band. Hope to see you all there and say hi.
Hey, you got me on the Replacements, but
and Brad
I got
says,
it, though. I know the Replacements.
Credit, but the Matt. Air Supply guest for the Asthmatics was underrated and underappreciated.
That was me.
Man, kill it off that, 5-0.
So don't give Brad credit.
That wasn't me. That was not me, okay? It was not. That was 5-0. I'll give him 100% credit for that.
Yeah, I've been a Weezer fan for a long time, and I've never heard that. Ask everybody if she knows who the Mats are.
I do now,
but I know the Replacements.
Talking about it. I used to think I was up on pop culture, but you guys are just confusing me.
Well, you're old, man.
Wow.
He's not as old as I am.
All right.
What's that got to do with knowing what pop culture?
Chaz old. Keeping it real.
All right, Tommy Whopper.
We felt
that was one time. Out
Saturday night with the Chantourage.
Yeah, 5-0 was out with the Chantourage moon.
Do you know that after we left, at some point, he had security go up there
and remove a guy.
And remove
four people.
Four guys from the
I'll get my hat.
He's like, you got to go.